Censorship. It does some good. No, wait. No, it doesn't. So, I got this video idea from a channel called The Happy Spaceman Reviews, who did a list of the top 10 worst censored lyrics. Twice. For this video, I'm kinda gonna be doing what he did and analyze certain musical censorships that I've noticed and tell basically why I think the changes were dumb. So, without further ado, let's begin. Yes, Kidz Bop. For those unaware, Kidz Bop is a collection of CDs that have kids covering currently popular songs, and needless to say, it's not looked fondly upon. Not only because the kids don't have the best singing, but also because due to its aim of having music by kids for kids, they have to edit a bunch of lyrics from the original song to make it kid-friendly. And then some fucking times, they'll just change things for literally no fucking reason. Yep, Kidz Bop decided to cover Lucid Dreams by Juice WRLD, may he rest in peace. They're covering a song dealing with heartbreak and depression, and one, they make it sound happier than the original, which is already whiplash there, and two, the changes to the lyrics are really fucking stupid. Like, I get maybe changing, I take prescriptions to make me feel a-okay. To, I take precautions to make sure I'm a-okay. But then they change the stupidest shit, like changing, it's to the point where I love and I hate you. To, it's to the point where I love and I miss you. Like, why the fuck did that have to be changed? Do you think the kids, like, straight up don't feel hate? And trust me, it doesn't stop there. They then change the lines, you left me falling and landing inside my grave. I know that you want me dead. To, you left me falling and landing inside this mess. I know that you know I'm sad. Which, again, why did that have to be changed? I get kids may not fully grasp the idea of death at a young age, but I'm pretty sure they get the idea of someone dying even at that age. And hey, you're covering a depression song. If you didn't want it to be grim, you probably shouldn't have covered it in the first place. I get that Lucid Dreams was a big song back in 2018, but that's no excuse. WAP was a big song last year, and for obvious reasons, Kidz Bop never even touched that. Now from the top, make it drop, that's some wet ass pussy. So it's not like they had to cover Lucid Dreams. In fact, the world would be a much better place if they didn't. They even changed the line, who knew evil girls had the prettiest face? To, who knew that these ones have the prettiest face? Like, are we not allowed to say evil anymore? Is that a swear word that society arbitrarily says is the work of the devil? Cause if that's the case,
guys, I'm gonna say the evil word.
It should be obvious to everyone that I'm a huge fan of Insane Clown Posse. Hell, why do you think I renamed myself the Shangri-La Slayer? But I just can't get past this music video. Not for what's shown in the video, but for what they did to this specific song. Back in 1999, ICP released The Amazing Jekyll Brothers, and one of the singles off that album was Another Love Song, and I honestly really like it. Violent J isn't the best singer, but his over-the-top lyrics and delivery really sell it for me. That was until I saw the music video for it. Now, censoring ICP is already a stupid fucking idea since, you know, they're kind of known for being potty mouths, but not only do they censor the swear words, they censor words that aren't even swear words. In fact, here's every single word or phrase censored in the music video version. Shit. Ass. Kill. Bitch. Cut. Neck. Choke out that bitch ass. Chop. Fucked. Stick a 10-pound axe in your daddy's forehead. Fuck. Wipe his nut. Killed your cat, him, fucking, choke you, slap you, bang your head on the wall, in the video it's bang my head, dying, and die. You see the issue with this list? I know it's hard to tell, but in case you didn't notice, literally half of these aren't fucking swear words. Sure, they're violent, but one, that should have been your sign to, you know, just not touch a song in the first place, and two, that doesn't change the fact that half of these words by themselves are not swears. And wait a minute, why do they censor every other mention of killing, but when Violent J says he would kill off some bears and dogs, that's the only time where it's okay? I could kill off some bears and dogs. Give me a fucking break. I'll also never be able to look into the mind of the absolute dumbass who decided that the word him was worth censoring. Not to mention that the way the chorus is reversed kinda makes it sound like Violent J singing I'd rather piss in his ass. I'd rather do this in his ass. So congrats, you tried to make the song cleaner and you failed in the absolute most brilliant of ways. Have the Idiot Award. Fuck the Police is a controversial song by N.W.A. off of their debut album Straight Outta Compton. It's a song dealing with the issue of police brutality and racial profiling, and it was really controversial at the time. Hell, it was so controversial that the FBI threatened N.W.A.'s record label for releasing such a vile song, claiming it encouraged violence towards the police. It's a damn good song, and it still holds up today given, you know, recent events. But then in 1999, a new metal band called Dope released their debut album Felons and Revolutionaries, and one of the tracks on that album is a cover of Fuck the Police. And, if I can be brutally honest here, it's kinda shit. Not only did It's So Dope's vocals sound to being recorded underwater and the instruments sound to being recorded by fucking robots, they had to change some of the lyrics and, searching my car, looking for the product, thinking every nigga is selling narcotics. Yeah, this kind of line doesn't work in a song about racial profiling. In Ice Cube's original line, it was referring to how the police automatically assume that he has drugs in his car purely based off of the fact that he's black. But with here, you're flat out admitting that you're selling drugs. Why should I feel bad for you? You're obviously doing something illegal, which is the opposite of what the original line had going for. Like, I get the reasoning of why they changed it, as Edso is clearly white, but this line goes against the original intent of the song and turns what's originally about a very serious issue into the cops pulled me over and took my cocaine and yeah. Can you tell I'm not a fan of this cover? Cause yeah, I'm most definitely not. And I'm the guy who will stick up for most nu metal bands, so that's saying something.